In 2016, Elon Musk announced his ambitious vision that future Tesla vehicles would soon run their self-driving AI software on their own chip. That is, a chip designed by Tesla itself. By 2018, the chips were ready, and by 2019, Tesla had switched over to them. When Elon Musk pitched the idea of developing its own chips at the AI conference, he mentioned that the processing power of these customized AI hardware chips would make Tesla's cars safer. According to him, with these chips, Tesla's vision to create self-driving cars that drive 10 times more safely than a human will become a reality much sooner. Hence, Tesla would be able to save more lives much earlier than it initially thought it would. So, let's go under the hood a little and see what Tesla's chip, the future self-driving computer, looks like. So you probably can tell that designing a processor chip isn't small work. These chips have 6 billion transistors. But when you're Tesla and you have all the needed experience in-house, from processing manufacturing to software development, things become decidedly easier. And this is what keeps Tesla ahead of its competition. Other automakers have to deal with expensive hardware, outdated technology, and all the issues that come with depending on suppliers. But these issues are nearly absent with Tesla. So the company easily sets the standards for mass-market autopilot. Anyway, let's go back under the hood. Each computer in a Tesla car comes with 2 AI chips. It's called a redundant design, and it's there for a purpose, which is to ensure that Tesla's cars are super safe. So there's redundancy in the power supplied by the chips, as well as the data input feeds as well. The car's cameras also run on 2 separate power supplies, simply to ensure that there are no failures of any kind and nothing unexpected happens to the system if something fails, like say a sensor or a camera or power supply. The redundant design also ensures that the car always makes the best decisions, which is another important factor that enhances self-driving safety. Just like human-driven cars, self-driven cars also have to make assessments and judgment calls, and these cars depend on their built-in chips to do that. So, the chips must be as accurate as possible, which is another reason a redundant design is important. This way, each chip makes its own assessment of what the car should do next, looking at the situation on the ground. When each chip makes its assessment, it submits it to the computer, which then compares both assessments and takes action if both assessments are in concert. However, if the chips disagree, then the car throws away that data and the process starts again. This is why it's so important that these cars come with powerful chips with the ability to handle super high video frame rates. Another thing about Tesla's FSD is that it is highly optimized. Each chip runs at 2 GHz and can perform about 70 trillion operations per second. Yep, wow is right. This is actually mind-blowing. And this level of performance is possible because Tesla specifically optimized its chips for self-driving cars. So anything that's generic or not super specific to that purpose, Tesla dropped from the design altogether. For instance, instead of 16-bit floating-point numbers, Tesla's AI chips handle data as 8-bit integers. 16-bit integers are the common way most AI tasks are recorded, but then again, processing them requires a lot of power, so Tesla cut that down. Again, Tesla's chips only process a very limited set of instructions, which is another huge score for efficiency. One other thing is the SRAM memory. The chip comes with a massive 32 megabytes of high-speed SRAM memory. And what does this mean? Well, it means that the chip does not have to wait all day trying to get data from the conventional DRAM memory, which is a lot slower than the newer and faster SRAM memory. Like Das Sarma, the principal autopilot hardware architect at Tesla, said, the company wanted to spend less power on profligate things and more energy on the things that really matter to it. Tesla took about 14 months to design the AI chip, focusing especially on designing the core AI elements of the processor. For other elements like graphics processing, however, Tesla simply used off-the-shelf elements. Nevertheless, as wonderful as this innovation seems, there are, of course, those who have their worries about the technology. And those worries are worth looking into. Let's look at the redundancy assertion, for instance. It's true that redundancy capabilities are essential, especially when it comes to life and death aspects that come while driving a car. But there are issues to be considered if decision-making is going to be delayed each time the chips disagree. Issues like, what if the chips continue to disagree? Is the car just going to continue postponing its driving decisions? Imagine there was a fully loaded tanker ahead of the car, and the car needed to make a decision to swerve or not. In that situation, not making a decision would obviously not be the best strategy. Also, since decisions are dependent on the chips agreeing, what if the chips agree to make a bad decision? What happens then? Well, a possible solution to this would be to create another redundant system that is separate and not identical to the other chips. This will act as a control system that helps to keep the other chips in check and overcome the possible flaws that could arise from working with a merely duplicated system. Now, another big challenge that faces Tesla's FSD is what you could call the curse of the first gen. If you know anything about chip design, you definitely know that the first generation of any newly designed chip often comes with a slew of bugs and latent errors, and Tesla's chip is not exempt from this reality. Still, none of this is to say, however, that Tesla has not done something truly stunning in the development of its AI chips. The chips perform about 70 trillion operations per second and analyze 2100 frames of video per second. This makes the FSD 21 times faster than older generation hardware. The numbers are truly impressive, and we look forward to how Tesla would be navigating and innovating around the current shortcomings of its newly designed chip. For more videos like this, subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell notification so you never miss an upload. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys in the next video.